this one... Eric's on loser's side.
Right, this is one loss side. The loser is done. Well, they're both done. Right, well, 9 through 12.
9 through 12.
Yeah.
Because you're trying to get down to 4 on the losers, 4 on the winners.
Right.
And they already went home. Yeah. Two of them are Hammonds.
Right.
One car problem, and they're both not going to make it back.
You remember years ago when Tony Robles won the BCA tournament in Vegas?
Okay.
I remember I wasn't even familiar with him because he's an East Coast player. Yeah. He doesn't come out and play a lot of pro events. So I started asking people, you know, Tony Robles, tell me about him. And everybody is like, Tony is the nicest guy in the world. And I thought, there is no pool player who everybody thinks is the nicest guy in the world. You know, pool players, they all have a problem with somebody. So I thought, you know, there's something weird going on there. And then I met him and did an interview with him, and he is the nicest guy in the world. You just, you know, you meet him, you're like, wow. You know, if the pool world had more guys like this.
And he's a prime example. He does not get into his own events. He's a promoter, and he stays out of it. Then if you have to watch a call or if you have to make a decision, you don't have, it's not a conflict of interest.
Right.
That's a huge deal, you know? Just super nice. Him and Gail ran the tournament there and everything at Steinway. And, you know, they've carved out a living in the billiard industry, which is not easy.
Yeah.
And I wanted to go to a few more pool halls while I was there, but we had to do every tourist thing in the world there. That was kind of the agreement with the wife that we went to every single tournament of thing in the world there, every tourist trap, trade towers, Empire State Building, you know, all of them, the state, everything. So he had to get home from the vacation and take a vacation because it wore you out.
Well, if Derek plays like he did, well, actually, if Eric plays like Mike did, then yeah, Derek's gonna have an easy run.
I think Derek wins this.
Yeah, he's playing strong.
Yeah, I think he wins this.
Eric looks bored over there. You can see on the camera.
If you guys ever want to pick up a card for the Arizona Billiard Academy, they're at GQ Billiards there in Tempe, off of I-10 and Warner. So they have all my cards.
Oh, okay.
I'm the one they recommend if somebody comes in looking for lessons or anything like that. And another service that the Academy offers is Key Repair.
Okay, yeah, and you do that. Did you do that in some of the pool rooms?
Correct. I have a completely mobile system. Like tomorrow, I'll have to give up some play in the pro event, and I have to go down to, and tomorrow I'll be set up at Scott Freezer's ice house. And the luxury with me is I do it right in front of your eyes. There's no dropping it off. There's no anything. You know, if I cut a face in a new tip and you're like, I like it a little bit different, I want it sanded a little bit more, you know, I've got this nick and you worked on it great, but I want it a little bit more, things like that. So it's right in front of your eyes.
Yeah.
But I set up at all the pool halls. And if I give you lessons, if we're doing lessons either in the academy or at your home, if you have a couple of tips that need to be done, I run into the wife needs ones, cues, and then the husband has cues, and then the son has cues, and everybody has a break cue. So I just bring my machine with me, and I just do all the work right there.
There you go. And what prompted you to venture... Jesus, venture into Q repair.
So, 25 years ago, I opened a retail store in my hometown of Oregon, North Bend, Oregon, 9,600 people, 13 stoplights. And everybody would come in for a tip. And they didn't want to buy a new cue or buy supplies. They wanted a tip. So I told myself I needed to learn how to do cue repair. So I started asking around how can I learn this? And so I bought the DVD, well, back then they were VHSs, and I bought the machine, and I had I had a little TV with a VHS in the bottom, and I would just play the tape, push pause, do the work, see if mine looked like theirs.
I'm betting you didn't do that in front of the customers.
No, that was 20 some years ago. And but I had a lot of downtime, and you know, I had a lot of downtime in a retail store. Not everybody walked in all the time, you know, and stuff. So I learned it, and then I did it inside of Hard Time Sacramento in California. Like I said, I worked on Efren. Mike Massey would stay with me. I worked on his tips. He still remembers this to the day. I worked on his tip every day, just shaping it and just making sure it was perfect. He won the big event. He won $5,000.
Wow.
He beat that Mike, the one you said he won at Sands twice, Mike.
Davis.
Davis, he beat him. And and then here in Phoenix, when I wanted my own work done, everything was set up to have a drop-off. Everything was legal. Well, if my house catches on fire, I'm getting my cues out before anything. I don't leave my cues.
Right.
You know, I don't leave my cues in the car. I don't leave my cues with anybody. So that didn't work for me. And so I just wanted to offer it as another service of the academy. I'm also in people's homes, and they can't do a draw shot because their tip's so bad.
Right.
So I had to try to recommend them out and stuff like that. So, make a long story short, then that's how, and it's kind of taken off. I started in pool halls, and now I have other pool halls contacting me. Hey, can you come in? I have tours. Hey, can you come in during the tour? If somebody pops a tip, if something happens, you know, they can get their shafts clean right before they start. You know, that kind of thing. So, and the only downside of that is that it takes away from what I really love to do, and that is play. You
right.
know, that's what I really love to do. When they're behind us, it really echoes right up into it.
Well, Eric has a different plan than what you were thinking was going to happen here.
Yeah.
Although I think he lost Whitey there. He might. Yeah, I guess you can still see the edge.
It's a long ways to 8, though.
Yeah. That was nice speed. A little more than he wanted, but can't complain.
And if things keep going well, it's dangerous.
I don't think that's what he meant to do.
He's going to fire this ball.
I was told that Eric had really upped his game lately. Been in a lot of action, playing real confident.
And I think he would have been a 9, but then he just kind of took a break there and he never actually got raised.
That's pretty sporty.
You can't stop him doing that.
Yep. While he's racking, I will be right back.
Okay. great break except for the scratch. So he's going to end up with ball in hand. Let's see if the momentum can change here. Having a hard time finding the cue ball currently. There we go. I think this is a big rack for Derek. He needs to get out here. Eric had a nice break and he scratched. Let the cue ball loose, and then this is what Derek's doing with ball in hand. And this was a big rack to get out on. He needs to get all the way out. See, he's not chalking. He's not chalking.
Well, but he's not just putting anything on it either. He's rolling everything in.
I'm a chalker. I like to chalk.
Yeah.
And that slows me down a little bit too, like we talked about, you know. And he's using that black chalk over there, and I don't know which flavor of chalk it is, so maybe it's one of the extenders. Have you run into what we're seeing in the valley where the chalk won't come off the balls? Some of the high performance chalks?
Although, you remember, Main Street, they wouldn't let them use Kawamura.
Right, I'm saying that's what I didn't know if I should mention it. Yeah, they still, to this day, he just swears it won't come off in his ball cleaner, and it won't come off the table. So Kamui's made a special cleaner.
Oh.
But it's like, well, why should I go out and invest in more stuff just because the... So.
I remember 30 years ago when I was playing at DJ's up on Cave Creek Road. I don't remember what got me started, but I found a cube of red master chalk.
Okay.
And I was using that for a time. And
they freak out about red now.
Oh my God. The owner saw it and he said, You're not using red anymore. And I said, okay, let me just run this, you know, let me just finish this rack. And he said, no, you're not using red anymore. Oh.
Yeah.
And you could see it too.
So I'm a master guy. That's what I grew up with. You know, I don't know everything about every piece of chalk in the world, but I'm a master guy. So, but when I play with the green, it shouldn't matter, but it plugs my tip.
The green and the blue have a different consistency.
It's finer. Yeah. And I miscue. And it's not supposed to be. It's supposed to be, you know, but yeah. So speaking of red, at my house, when we had our family table in the basement for 30 years, some salesman came by and talked my dad into red felt. So I grew up, I didn't know there was anything else when I grew up. It was red. We had red chalk and red felt for 25 years. But
I remember years ago talking to somebody at one of the, it wasn't GQ, but it was someplace like that. They said that married couples would decide they were going to get a pool table for their home. The husband would come in and say, I'm here to pick out the table. And they would say, okay, and which cloth do you want? Oh, no, my wife will come in and pick that out.
Right.
Do you want her to wash? Yeah, that's what I was thinking.
Yeah, so.
Go to ustream.tv/channel/turning-stone. Yep, that's it. I've got to do something about that channel. If Upstate is streaming and we're streaming, then we have to use Turning Stone. And it's so goofy.
Yeah, we got to get these guys to just install a camera so you don't have to pack 5,000 pounds of stuff in here, too. And just, you know, like Hard Time Sacramento, they just have their own channel. Yeah. Ustream channel. Is that free?
Yeah.
Okay. So, you know, he's got
a... Well, and Chester's has a camera pointed at a table.
Yeah.
Main Street does.
Yep.
Old shooters. But a lot of them, you know, they're pointed at it, but they're not online anymore.
Yeah.
You know, because, like, Lenny will come in and set it up for a room, but as soon as you get an error on the screen, nobody knows what to do.
Right. Yep.
They had a nice setup at Griff's. They had a TV table that was well lit, and they had cameras permanently, but they couldn't get us into it.
If anybody listening doesn't end up winning the JB case that's in this raffle, GQ Billiards is now an authorized supplier of JB's. Yep. Yeah, a few weeks and their big order will be in, but they can take anything or make anything or, yep.
GQ's a sponsor of our tour.
Yep.
When you're in there, make sure you thank them for helping out with the tour. They're also a sponsor of the Straight Shooters Tour. I think they're probably involved with the AWBT too.
Yep. Yeah, they really... They're the only real huge supply, you know, where you can go in and really look at stuff and try, and they have all the low deflection shafts and everything. You'll see RJ and Heather's on the team there. And
just over there yesterday.
And, you know, you can't go in anywhere and see all the Predators and all the Jacobies and all that stuff. I just like going there and drool about, you know, I mean, it isn't like it's just in a catalog somewhere, so.
Well, and what's really bad is when you see customers come in and they want to try out the cue, and then when they pick out the cue they want, they go home and order it online.
Yeah. They'll end up getting ripped more than anything on that. It'll get you. It'll come in crooked. There's no warranties. There's no... And that's anywhere. You go to a regular hardware store and get the knowledge and go to Walmart and buy it. But, you know, you'll end up in... You'll end up worse off in the long run. Q-sticks are so picky, and they will warp, and they'll, you know, the tip flies off or something. At least if you're with GQ, they take care of everything. They warranty everything. You know, you can just go in there and they match internet. If you really get down to the nuts and bolts with them, it's going to be okay. If you, you know, if it sounds
forever,
you know, if it sounds too good to be true online, it probably is. And then another thing, they always just jack up $15 to $20 for shipping. So it's like, oh, that just added to that queue massively here. I thought I was going to save, you know, $7-$8, and boom. So, and then if there's something wrong, you pay to ship it back.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I wrote stuff up on Facebook about buying online. It's a misnomer. Wow, that was quite a shape. Wow.
Yeah.
Wow. Yeah, you're right. Odair's got to get going here. This is starting to get a little three-game deficits. He'll eat you alive. Yep.
Yeah, boy, we were talking about how the matches were going fast. We're 5 racks into this, and we're 20 minutes in.
Yep. 3.5 by 7 is a huge difference.
Yeah.
Huge difference.
I remember the first time I ran the tour, we played 9-foot 8-ball, and there were players who said that it was the most brutal game.
Yep.
8-ball on a 9-foot table. I mean, you know, the pros play at IPT, but...
They even made it harder by having the shag carpet, too.
Yeah.
So. But, you know, they're pros. They can move balls around, and... This is an amateur. This is a...
Now tomorrow, the races will have to be longer.
Yep. And
he's
still
not going to like it.
No.
Speaking of shag carpet, have you played on the Chinese 8-ball table?
I haven't. There was a couple at the BCA trade show, and just kind of rolled some... Well, in fact, there was two at the Rio. Mm-hmm. And then there was one or two at the BCA trade show, and then there's one at Colby's now. But no, I don't have any need for it. I don't do, if I want to really challenge myself, I go to Main Street and play on the snooker table. I have a hard enough time just in normal, let alone trying to, worry about all that. But.
That was a nice shot. That was tricky.
It really was. It could have turned out ugly so fast. It's unreal. He still almost twisted that ball.
Well, I think he made the two.
No.
Oh.
He got a roll.
Yeah. Because if he'd have made the two, he'd have been in real trouble.
Yep.
Oops.
Okay. So if all goes well, it'll be 4-2 if all goes well. Well, this table is fooling him every time. Sometimes cue ball is coming that end, sometimes coming this end. I'm confident.
He's
out.
Yeah,
I'm confident.
So. Don't want to go out too far on a limb, but.
Yeah, you start getting away from that rail, it's going to make that six harder. His body language is not that confident.
You hit that perfect.
Yeah. He must be using high performance chalk because he's not chalking at all. Yeah, 4-2. That's a good match.
Oh, he's using the black one over there on the
left. Yeah, that's his black one.
It almost looks like Balabushka.
Yeah.
Oh, well, isn't Kamui
if he
black
wins
too?
The match, we'll say it's Balabushka. Yeah. If he loses, I must have something else, man. You don't lose the Balabushka. You know, another thing with today, we don't have arguments, we don't have sharking, we don't have, you know, fist to blows, we don't have a lot of that. It's been pretty clean, pretty fast, no arguments, no...
Yeah, today's been smooth.
Not too much come watch this hit type thing.
And you know, Chuck and I run the tour. When Lenny got hired with Scott, we knew Lenny wasn't going to be available to come out and stream anymore. So when I got the gig to stream Portland, I knew that I could come out and do this. And at that time, I just told Chuck, look, the tournament's yours.
Yep.
You don't need me micromanaging things. You know, he may not do everything the way I would do it, but he's ran more than his share of tournaments. He knows what he's doing.
Yeah. You haven't had any redraws or anything like that, so yeah. No, if anybody listening has ever ran a tournament, you understand how it's not easy.
Oh yeah, there's always something that goes wrong.
It is. You're dealing with a lot of people. You're dealing with a lot of personalities. You're dealing with a lot of passion. You're dealing with a lot of money. That is a lot of money that's in there. And you do one little thing wrong with change or what you thought you had, and you're reaching in your own pocket to make it right instead of trying to explain how they got screwed up. So,
Well, I've done that with the newspaper a few times. You know, you screw up an ad and they say, no, it was 250 added, not 500. Oh, well, I guess it's 500 now.
Yeah. Eric's playing flawless. Eric's playing great.
Well, and it's like night and day difference with Derek.
It ain't who you play, it's when you're playing.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yep. Absolutely night and day. I don't know if I can do this for very long. I have to bring my pillow. Man.
Yeah.
Woo!
I'll be lucky you're not playing. We're not doing this on those short tables.
Yeah.
Because then you're leaned over the whole time.
So this is the last stream of the night.
Yep.
Yep. And you start back tomorrow.
Yeah.
Does it tell us how many people are watching?
No. Wow, we're getting compliments all the way from Hawaii. George Teachea.
Oh, good.
He's coming home from Hawaii tomorrow.
Ask him if he made it to Hawaii, Brian's.
He might have.
Because he was in Waikiki, so. Waikiki just felt like New York or San Francisco. Just too much in too small of a space for me.
Are you guys playing the ball? Are you guys playing the tournament?
Yeah.
So, were you around when they banned the Calcuttas?
Mm-hmm. I was around before they banned them.
Yeah. I grew up with Calcuttas.
Pool was huge when there were Calcuttas. Oh my lord.
So when they're posting winnings and money and things, is that ever going to go get us in trouble? Is that ever going to come back to haunt one of the places?
Now, now you're good.
You know what? Grady. Whoa. Grady got after me on AZ Billiards because I was listing tournament bags. And he said, I don't want my information up out there. And he did the whole, well, the IRS is going to see it and they're going to, the IRS is not going to see AZ Billiards. And
for me, it's like, in Oregon, you have your liquor license, and then you have the state lottery.
Yeah.
So you had to be really careful, because if they thought they were spending 30 cents extra on something that they could have been spending on the lottery, they got mad.
Right.
So, there's a lot of volume when you're starting having these big chip tournaments and stuff.
Oh, sure.
You know, and then does Uncle Sam want, does it from the business or the liquor license? But you've been around a lot longer than I have. I just wonder, kind of what your thoughts on that stuff. I mean,
I've carried on multiple conversations with the liquor board, and it's the liquor board that outlawed it. There are ways around it, but, the question is it worth it?
See, his body language on that one, he didn't shoot that seven with confidence.
Yeah.
Now he's left himself hard. And we all know if you don't get out of this rack, it's all but over. That's a very, very nice shot. That was a very nice shot under a lot of pressure. 3-5. That is a big difference between 6-2. That is a big difference. I'm not a mathematician, but if you did the math on that, it'd be a lot. Your odds of winning are. Yeah, for sure.
Well, we know somebody's watching because we just got a text. Did not make it to Hawaiian Brian's. Hanging out with some friends, waiting to head to the airport and join you guys.
George Teachea.
Yep.
Tell him you didn't miss anything.
He'll be here. He's landing at 7:30. He'll be here tomorrow.
Good.
His nephews played today.
I just want to be able to.
Yeah, I heard that. I heard that last name.
This is the only tournament table we're using right now for tonight. As soon as this match is over, we'll close it up for the tournament.
Just want to make sure that they were asking.
I know.
Yeah.
I know that he rented that one back there. Now that we are having a tournament tonight, so probably within the next 20 to 30 minutes, they'll say.
Yeah, you're probably going to have to watch them because they don't understand the tournament going on.
Oh, yeah.
They're just general users.
Chuck's on his way. He's on top of it. Telling him, hey, it's not going to work. Are they going to take the ball with him? He's picking up the cue ball. Yeah, just took the cue ball to the other table.
That one should have its own cue ball.
Derek was going for an early 9 ball and hung it in the jaws. And Eric went for an early 1 too, and he made the 1. That's a sporty shot.
Look how fast he's playing, man. Everything's just going perfect.
Yeah. Let's see, gets hooked there.
Wow.
Did he really?
Yeah.
Full ball.
Full ball. See, I'm one rail over by the chalk, just like he's gonna do. That's what I do. I just. You can't live in a pass, can't kick yourself. But if they gave you $1 million to make that ball all the way up there and stick behind that seven, yeah. You could.
Yeah, you try to play safety doing that,
yeah.
You could sell it out.
No, everything's going his way, even at 5-3, he just needs to stick with it.
Well, Derek's gotta get out here.
Yeah.
And there's not any real reason for him not to.
No. You can see the crowd's changing. It's the Saturday night partiers.
Yeah, it's getting loud.
There's nothing wrong with that. That's who pays the bills. You got to get them in here. You got to get them. Got to get them happy and paying the bills.
Okay, so getting back within one.
This is going to be tricky. Is he going to move the nine? He's going to move the nine.
Where's the nine going? He's going to have to bank it.
Yep.
Well, he may be able to cut it.
In the side pocket.
Oh no,
shit.
How do you do that?
Shit. I told you that nine was going to move.
Yeah.
And if it didn't, then he's going to have to move his cue ball over to get it.
Look at this.
Just like he had eyes. That was a very nice shot.
What were you saying? It's all rolling in Eric's direction
right now. Yeah. Derek's key thing is Derek and Eric. Derek's key thing is stop the bleeding.
Yeah.
Even if you had to play the safe where you just send the cue ball up table and leave it in the
eight.
He had to take Derek had to take more care on that nine ball because he could have just even played that safe where he left it in the middle of the rail and sent the cue ball up table. Could have cut it. Could have banked it. Could have went something. Cut banked it, but. That was a big nine ball.
Seemed like he rushed it a little.
That was a big nine ball.
Yeah, that's honestly supposed to be the match right there.
Starting to get three games down. But if he can get one back here and we get some combos going, this is a wild nine.
Yeah.
But that's weighing on his head. That's weighing on everything.
Now he's trying to play safe.
Yep.
Safety worked.
We'll just leave it down there.
Got a call in hand. Does the three go by the eight?
Yeah. I don't know. Without moving that two, he could have played another safe and went for a three foul. But now that one's all the way out, do you try to get behind the 3-8?
No.
It goes by. It goes by there, he shot it. He miscued again.
Oh, no.
Yep, that was a miscue, you heard it.
Yeah. Jesse Johnson did that three times. And it was all three times that he was trying to put a heavy stroke on it.
He's got to get to GQ Billiards and get himself some. Malabushka chalk.
Maybe that's it. He should chalk his cue more.
Yeah, I noticed. I picked it up. He wasn't. I told you he wasn't. Barring any unforeseenness.
Yeah.
He's got the lead. He's got the momentum.
I mean, he's going to have to stroke the 8 to the 9. Oh, he hit that awfully hard.
He's not jockeying either.
And he's using master, isn't he?
Wow.
Hit that
inside.
Pretty strong. Yeah.
Inside spin. Wow, that was a great shot. Do you shoot that if you're down three games, though? Yeah. Yeah, that's great. That's what it takes. That was a great shot. That shortens that last rail up so you don't have that hungry pocket
right.
screaming at you.
All right, Eric's last break. Shot on the one.
Got an edge.
Yeah, I don't know about the two, and I think the six goes. He doesn't shoot the combo here. He's not riding that high.
He's using high.
He deserved better than that.
Yep, he'll just send you to the rail and behind the pack. A little strong, a little hard, but he caught him. Yeah, it was a little hard. Came into the backside a little hard.
You think he left him?
Yep.
Left him enough of the two?
Yep. This is the longest he's taken all match. This is the longest he's taken on a ball. You know, he's on. You know.
Oh, he didn't have enough of it.
That was a nice shot.
Yeah, it left him safe, but I think Eric's going to just play him safe right back. Yep. They teach that safety in sixth school.
Yeah.
Where is he jumping to? Is he jumping trying to go jump kick?
I was going to say jump to a rail.
Yeah, unless you can jump to the edge of it.
I think he's jumping to the top rail. Yeah, just like that.
That's a nice shot, yeah.
That was a nice shot. Didn't even have all the ball. It was just a good hit. Maybe that's going to jumpstart him. He's going to come firing back here. Didn't get much of a leave on that two ball.
He'll make the two.
He's okay.
Yeah, I was just thinking that's not a real big window.
Nope. That's definitely touching. It sounds like he miscues every damn time. That's a good shot. That was a good shot. Wow, that was a good out. 4-7. I still think it maybe just be a little too late because he let Eric all the way to the hill.
Yeah.
You know, that would have been 4-6 or something, but we'll see.
We've all seen it happen.
Yeah. Yeah. maybe Rob Green, maybe RJ's listening too, because he called me. RJ, if you're listening, tap three times.
All right, need a ball. He's got a bank on the line.
Yeah.
The Derek that we watched play earlier would bank this ball in like it was nothing.
Yep, fired it. Oh, this Derek's chalking though, so.
Uh-oh.
He got below it.
Wow.
That was a great shot. He had the two if he had to. Or, yeah. Well, we know Eric will hit it because he's a great jumper. Then we'll just decide if what's going to happen after that.
Well, once the two is taken care of, I think whoever makes the two wins the game. How are you trying to get back on the two, though?
Yeah, you didn't have much of a plan. You know, you're jumping. You just try to hit it.
Yeah.
It's almost like he miscued a little bit because I think he wanted to get a little more momentum out of that one ball. He wanted it to ride a little more, fly.
He can go under the two here. Yeah, just like that.
Just like that. Yeah. I think you're back to your scenario. This is the game winner. Or the other.
Yeah. I mean, the eight ball moved a little bit. That might change things a little. But really, if you get on the seven, you're not going to have any problem getting on the eight.
Oh. That's a damn good try, though. That was a damn good try.
And he didn't have much else.
Nope. And matches go that way. Shit just doesn't go your way sometimes.
Wow.
But did he get a roll?
I think he can see it.
He's not jumping up to it.
Ooh.
Wow. So when you're at Turning Stone, it must be boring because those pros just run out.
Well, there's a lot of it, yeah.
Oh, he back cut that ball. Wow, that was a great shot. It's got perfect shape here just to come over for the eight. That's very, very nice.
7-5. D-backs are back within one.
Very nice.
He's not completely out of the woods.
No, he's a drawer. He's going to draw this ball.
I've underdrawn this ball before. He has.
Perfect. Absolutely perfect. I wish he'd chalk up. He bugs me.
You want to walk out there and give him a cube of chalk?
God, I got seven of them here. If we just stack it up, he'll see him. Making a good match out of it.
Oh, yeah.
The way it started was a runaway. Yeah, I've lived all over the West Coast, and there's just no place like Phoenix for pool. I mean, pool is just...
We went to that tournament in Portland 3 months ago. That was beautiful. They were teasing me, saying, you know, well, it's not normally this good of weather, but... look at... Is he hooked? Oh. Yeah. That changes things a lot.
So then you wonder if the inning end of the and that ball hung long enough for the inning to end, and then does it go back up?
I think the rule's 5 seconds.
It had to be close. The balls all stopped.
Yeah. That changes everything.
Yeah. Which, that means he's not going to lose on an early 9-0, too. So he needs to play more conservative than Eric does.
That safety could have ended up a lot worse.
Yeah. Go your way, the rolls go your way.
Yeah.
He's got him with a full.
He's no, go up and back.
Can't do anything with it. That was an excellent hit. He didn't right. have much of the cue ball or nothing. He banked that ball. Very nice.
He did. It got perfect on the two.
Yep.
It looks like making, yeah, he's looking at it now. You make the six, the seven goes on the side, you're out.
Yep. I never miss a ball from over here.
As bad as I play, I might have. Where's he going?
He's going the 5-9 combo.
Really? No.
I don't know.
No, he's not.
No. He's going to take it inside.
But he got funny on the six.
Well, he got funny on the five.
Yeah. Well, he knows this. He wins this game. He's in the money.
Yep.
Now he's got to play safe. He played a good
nice
one.
Nice touch. That's a nice touch.
I'm not liking to jump that.
No. Oh, he's gonna chalk over it, so.
Oh, he's doing that Shane thing.
Oh, God. Steady long, steady wrong.
I'm always surprised when I see Shane use that method. It's like, you shouldn't have to use a method. You should just know where to hit the ball.
Yeah. You know, we were at the BCA trade show this year, and I haven't been in a while, but first of all, it switched over to a lot more, very nice hit. It switched over to a lot more barbecue products and, you know, home product stuff.
Yeah.
But, you know, I remember when whoever your rep was for that product, they were there. You could shake hands and get autographs, and they, you know, that was the whole point. They were there, the Lori Johns, the Avas, the, you know, the pros, that if they were selling Chanthia cloth, they were at that booth.
Yeah. Well, the pool industry was a lot stronger at one time.
Yeah. We just can't seem to get any outside sponsors. All the sponsors are just people that sell billiard equipment. Like poker got Toyota to do a, you know, but yeah.
Well, but look at the audience for poker.
Yep. It had nothing until they showed us the hands.
Yep.
Whoever figured that out. Yeah. Yep. Just like Indian tribes come for Indian gaming. Gosh, that's a license to print money.
Yeah. I think that's going to be it. I'm excited about next year's trade show.
In Chicago.
No, New Orleans. Never been there.
Yep. Yep. Better come off soft.
He's going to give it to him.
Yeah.
All right, 8-5, Eric Osburn. We are done for the night. We'll be back around 11:30 tomorrow for the open event, and then this will finish up. Normally Chuck brings them back around noon or 1. All right, everybody, thanks a lot.